Hey, what's going on? In this video, I'm going to answer a very, very commonly asked question. And the answer to this question is going to teach you and to show you how you can constantly get people to always review the website online video presentations that you are trying to direct people to. So if you've got some type of online website presentation or funnel that you want to take people to, the answer to Jan's question out of Germany is going to definitely change the game. So first off, I want to give a special thank you to Jan in out in Germany. So calling from a long way here. Writing in, I should say. So this is in response to a couple other videos that I got, and she basically is having this question. Again, I always encourage people, if you ever have any questions, just hit me up on CesarLRodriguez.com, check out my blog, and just drop me a little note, and this was actually hers. She said, first of all, I want to thank you for your amazing YouTube channel and blog. Really appreciate it. Pleasure, check out your vids. She's complimenting me a ton. Great way to get me to respond, by the way. this is just a really awesome testimony of the first couple paragraphs. But she says that she has a live webinar that she actually shows her prospects that's in German. So she sends people to that link, and she piques their interest and then tells them to check out the recorded webinar on YouTube. I guess I want to watch this video, but some have seen it and some don't when I go to follow up with them. So her question is, and she's got a couple of parts here, how do you get people really committed to check out the online presentation? What phrases do you use? She also says, she really is trying to find out the right verbiage and the right type of words. She says that she goes indirect. Awesome way to go. Going indirect, by the way, is, you know, instead of saying, hey, do you keep your options open? It's more like prospecting someone saying, hey, listen, I'm working with a company. They're doing a lot of expanding. They're looking for some people in the area. Who do you know that keeps their options open? You know, that type of approach. Again, I've got tons of videos on that as well. Check them out on my blog, CesarLRodriguez.com. She says she's really comfortable with that approach. She goes on to saying, I really like the concept of sending people to an online video where they can get all the information. Plus, everyone has about 3 to 5 minutes a day to call someone up and to have that prospect spend the hour checking out the presentation. I totally agree. So how do you get people to watch the whole presentation? All right, so really, this is a huge, huge question, and this is game changing. So this is what you do, Jan. And for anyone watching this video, the greatest way to get someone to committed to actually doing what they said that they're going to do is to hold their hand and walk them to the presentation versus just sending them a link. You see, with my team, I have always had this huge mantra, and this is one of the number one rules when you're working with me personally on my team, and this is like a massive violation. Whenever I'm dealing with my leaders, if I ever have anyone on their teams that have ever told me or used any type of verbiage like, hey, I sent someone a link, not only do I correct that behavior, but I go directly to their upline leader and say, listen, what's going on that this person is sending links? The number one rule that I've always had on my team is you never, ever, 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 never, ever, ever, under any circumstances, ever email someone a link to your online presentation video. Ever. Never. Have I made that clear? Here's why I say that. Because the minute you have that link is your posture. That is your presentation. The minute you give up the information and just make it freely accessible so that your prospect can check it out at any time, guess when they're gonna check it out? At any time. That's convenient to them, which is most of the time somewhere in the range of never, all right? So here's what ends up happening, and this is the scenario, and this is exactly how it plays out. You call up your prospect, you say, hey, you know, when will you have a couple minutes to check out this video? And they say, oh, you know, I've got a couple minutes later on this evening. Why don't you shoot me on over the link, Caesar, and I'll check it out. And the average person, because they're so excited to just get someone to agree to review some information, they quickly and excitingly shoot them over the email. Great, what's your email address? And then they get all excited and they're watching the phone for like the entire evening waiting for that prospect to call back, all right? Or they'll take it a next level, they'll take it a level up, and you know, maybe they'll try and control the phone. They'll say, great, well, what time can you watch? And the prospect will say, oh, I could watch it at 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock will work perfect for me. Shoot me over the link. And then once again, foolishly, you believe them and you send them the link, and guess what ends up happening? You call them at 8 o'clock, 8:30, as soon as the video's done, and then what does that prospect say? Well, they probably didn't pick up the phone because they probably didn't watch the video. Or, you know, maybe they do pick up the phone and they give you the really great excuse that's so believable and so true, and it's usually very, very just an awesome excuse, like, oh man, you know, my kid just, you know, he bumped his head and, you know, he's bleeding, I had to go to ER, whatever it is, it's always something, regardless. Listen, all excuses are equal, all right? That, to me, all I care about is the result. I don't care about the excuse, I don't care about the story, all right? So The result is they didn't watch it. So here's why that's happening, because you're releasing your control. So here's the rest of that outcome. What ends up occurring is when you do go to finally follow up with them, most of the time they're telling you like, well, hey, listen, you know, I didn't check it out, but listen, I'll check it out tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning's great. And then once again, you're following up. But on every follow up, you'll start to notice that you're losing more and more posture, and you're starting to feel more like you're pestering that person. Well, I made a commitment a long time in my business to never give out any information until that prospect is in front of a computer, ready to key in the website for the video online presentation that I want them to see. So for example, what I would encourage you to do, Jan, from now on, never give out the link. Now, first of all, I would not show a link to a YouTube video. If it's on YouTube, I would try to host that link on some type of web page. I don't know if you have a website, you can get a domain name, you know, and set up just like a one page thing, you know, that just might be like workwithjan.com or something like that. Just have a little website presentation that way you can send someone to a link other than just a YouTube video. Because number one, if you're sending them the YouTube, it's not very professional. And you know, chances are they're gonna watch that link, and then from there they're gonna see related videos, and they might scurry on off to a whole bunch of different other places. So I wouldn't encourage you to do that, because it's just too easy for them to get distracted. And again, a YouTube video doesn't have the same professionalism as sending them to a site with a more of a custom domain name. Now, it can still be a YouTube, just have it hosted somewhere else, and make sure no related videos pop up. All right, so with that being said, here's what you want to do. This is your new game plan and action plan. Next time you want to send someone to a video in an online presentation for your webinar, what you do is you call your prospect and you would say, hey, John, what's going on? It's Cesar Rodriguez. Listen, great. Once you've done your little spiel, whether you go direct or indirect, we're going to skip that. I've got plenty of other videos that cover those types of things. The minute you get that commitment for them to watch that video, what you want to do is you want to say, great. When are you going to be in front of your computer for, you know, about 30 to 45 minutes? All right, when will you have about 30 to 45 minutes to check out some information that's going to tell you everything about our company, the services we offer, and the kind of money you make? About what time would you have that time? And usually they'll give you a time. Again, the next step is giving them alternate choice codes. One would be easier for you: afternoon, evening, you know, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, you know, Monday, Tuesday, those types of things. All right, but again, scratching that, just keep it very basic. You want to get, once you get their commitment, they say, well, I could probably check out the video, you know, at this time. Say, great, here's what I'll do. This website that I need to log you onto, there's a website that I'd like you to check out that I'll actually need to log you onto. So I'll need to know when you'll be by your computer for about 30 to 45 minutes to check out this information. Now, they'll give you the time, and they'll usually say something like, great, yeah, shoot me over the link. At that point, this is where everything counts. This is where your posture is unbelievably important. What you need to do is you need to say, well, it's not really just a website link that I could just email you. There's a couple things that you actually need to do to make sure that you see the information properly. So really, what we need to do is we need to go ahead and just have that time where you're going to be in front of the computer. And when you're in front of the computer ready to check it out, what I'll do is I'll go ahead and I'll walk you through logging you onto that site so you can make sure you don't get confused, and you make sure that you watch the right video on there. All right. And again, another thing that I'll usually say is I won't get too specific on the website on the appointment. I'll say, well, listen, you know, we've got a couple of different websites that have got a couple of different videos. When are you going to be by a computer next where you'll have 30 to 45 minutes? And what I'll do is when you get in front of that computer, by then I'll have known which site is the perfect site to log you onto for the information that you're going to want to see. I probably will need to talk to my senior partner, to my executive, to my senior manager, whatever, and he'll kind of tell me which website is going to be best for you based on our conversation and what we just talked about and what you're going to want to see. So when are you going to be by computer? By that time, I'll have the information on what website to send you to, et cetera, et cetera. So bam, right from there, that way you've basically given like this obscure, I'm not even sure which site I'm going to give you, so obviously you can't email it to them. But by the time you're in front of that computer, I'll go ahead and do that. So treat your website online presentations the same way you would treat a physical presentation, right? If you were going to go sit down with someone and do a presentation, you wouldn't just like say, look, here, I'm going to email you my presentation, PowerPoint presentation or whatever, and then we'll talk about it when you get there. Why? Because once they have it, there's no need for them to follow up with you. So give it the same posture and give it the same oomph and require the same commitment to review the online presentation as you would a face-to-face presentation. All right, so again, get the appointment, set the appointment, and that way you control the follow-up. And again, if they ever say anything, if they're ever like, well, hey, listen, I'm in the bathroom right now, you know, I'll hop on the website as soon as I get a quick second, just go, look, I'm gonna write the link down. What's the website? I'll write it right down on toilet paper, and I'll walk over to the living room and check it out. do not give it to them. Say, listen, go ahead, take care of what you gotta do, flush the toilet, get in front of a computer, and I'll log you onto the site, all right? I'll call you right back. Or actually, hold on, let me go ahead and do some research and figure out which site it is that we're gonna log you onto. That'll be perfect timing, and by the time you're ready to sit down, and again, always qualify and say, look, great, do you have 30 minutes? If someone agrees to watch the video, that's not good enough. Say, look, would you have 30 minutes right now to go ahead and check it out? If I could get that information and log you onto the site. Find out if they do. If they say they don't, say, great, when will you have the time? Stay strong, your commitment. Don't give up any information, because the minute you give it up, they no longer need you to follow up. One last little tip I'll always tell people as well, if they ask, like, why can't you give it out? What's the deal? Why do we have to set up an appointment? A lot of times what I'll do, again, I love to lean on a third party expert, and you should definitely do that too. Say, great, we'll set this up. I'll get back with you on a couple of different times. A lot of times I'll tell people, I'll say, give me two or three times where you might be available. I'll see if I can call my senior partner. And what I'll do is they'll probably be the ones to log you onto that website. And then that way they can be free to talk with you afterwards and answer all of your questions. Again, make sure as soon as they're done seeing the presentation, the reason why you want to log them on is because if it's a 30-minute presentation, I want to log them onto that site and make sure, I want to know exactly when they're typing it in. I want to hear the video playing in the background, make sure there's no issues with it streaming slow, make sure that there's no distractions. And then as soon as they're done, as soon as I hear that video playing, I know in 30 minutes, I need to be ready to call them right back. All right, because I want to talk to them when it's fresh in their heads. So those are my tips. I'm telling you, if you start doing that and you create a culture where you never, ever, ever, ever give away your online presentation and you have your team duplicating, you guys are going to blow up, because 100% of every appointment you set to watch that presentation is going to stick. And no more will you have to lose your posture and call someone back and say, hey, you watch it yet? Oh, really? What happened? Oh, okay. So when's the next time you're going to be able to watch it? Oh, tomorrow? Okay, that'll be, okay, great. I'll call you tomorrow. And then you call them tomorrow and they're like, oh, something else happened. And then you're like, oh, okay, really? And then you get the almighty kiss of death. They just go, hey, listen, why don't I do this, Jan? I'll watch the video and I'll call you back when I'm ready and I'm done. Okay, great. And you've lost your follow-up forever. So if you want to keep the posture, use that approach. Hope that helps. I know it will. It's a game changer. It changed my business. It changed every person that I've ever coached in their business as well. So look forward to it. Again, if you ever have any questions and you're watching this video, feel free to hit me up. Check me out on my blog, CesarLRodriguez.com. I'll be more than happy to craft a little video for you, or just at least give you a quick little response. All right, thank you very much. Take care and have an awesome day.